cockroach here. It lives in Madagascar, and its scientific name is...
Gromphadorhina portentosa.
And, this is... Now, I think you may think, this is so disgusting. It crawls out in and out of garbages. But they're a lot cleaner than you think. Now, I don't know what happened to them, but usually these guys would have tiny bugs on their back. You might also think that would make them even more dirtier, but those bugs actually eat whatever's on it and making it dirty, and it cleans it up. Now, let's get to what these guys eat and drink. So they drink gel, liquid. Oh, he just hissed. Did you hear that? He drinks gel, and he will eat rotting fruits or vegetables, whatever you have. And it doesn't have to be rotting.
We just give him table scraps.
Yeah, he's like your composter, I guess. Mm-hmm. But so here's the way you can tell if it's a male or female. If you look very closely, it has little horns on there, right there. And before I say it, guess what you think it is in the comments. I will tell you in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so the cockroaches with horns are males, and the ones without horns are females. Now some, oh my god, what? He just hissed and then launched forwards. Anyways, the ones without horns are females, and the easier way to tell that is, I recently realized females have longer antennae than males as well. So sometimes these aren't as visible, because sometimes you're kind of looking at them in a darker area. You will not see that. So now let's get to what it looks like. Like, if you look, there's its head with its little small little jaws.
Do they bite?
They don't really bite. Honestly, don't touch their button. He just accidentally did that and he is angry. They don't bite, but honestly, I think the real pain when you're holding them is that they have little grips on their legs. So if you get a closer look, you can see all those tiny little grips. And they start sticking to your skin, and after a while it gets irritating. And I don't recommend just putting a whole bunch of them on you. If we flip them over, he
sticks.
Yeah, that's what those little things are for. But also, if you flip him over, it accidentally touches button. He hisses and falls. But,
I don't want him to fall.
Every night, I don't want him to fall. They're not as strong. Oh, my God. They're not as strong as you think. And as you heard in the name and just now, they hiss. They hiss whenever threatened. And this is a male, so he's a lot more hissy. And, He recently just had babies, so he's a lot more protective. He has a whole bunch of babies, and I want to show you. So we are going to show you a baby that now there is a baby that just molted, but since it's a little dangerous to touch a newly molted one, because you could possibly damage it or hurt it really badly, and I don't want to kill one of his babies, because he spent a lot of energy doing that, because they gotta eat like a whole bunch of stuff just to get enough energy to produce help the female produce. I mean, the female has to produce. Okay, the male.
Yeah, but we don't want to hurt the baby.
Yeah, that's the point.
All right. So we're going to go downstairs and film the babies?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Baby geckos. I'm sorry we haven't showed you the other batches, but this is a brand new batch. And this is one of the eggs one of them came out of. It's very hard. Since it's dried out. If it was like still hatching, it would be leathery and easier for them to get out, because if it wasn't like that, these guys don't have beaks, do they? They are not birds. Let's show you the babies. And he's a very pretty one. He seems to be quite energetic, but then when he gets on your finger, he just kind of like relaxes and stays there. He's a very sweet baby, and I hope he grows up to be a nice strong gecko.